Dearly beloved, we're assembled here in the presence of God to join this man and this woman in holy marriage, blessed by God and held in honor among all men. Let us therefore reverently remember that God has established and sanctified marriage for the welfare and happiness of mankind. God has instructed those who enter into this relation to cherish a mutual love and esteem. And now, as they make their promises to each other, may they make them with the deepest insight into their meaning and with the deepest sincerity. I charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, to remember that love and loyalty alone. If the solemn vows which you are about to make are to be kept permanent, your life will be full of peace and joy, and the home which you are establishing will abide through every change.
So you did upset him.
What did he do, go run this straight to you?
No, he didn't, but he was obviously upset. Now, I want to know what you told him.
You're not going to get the answer from me, so lay off.
No, I'm not going to lay off. Not to you, level with me.
You can get me angry, you know
that? Oh, well, good. Finally, somebody is getting you angry. You've been doing that to the rest of us for weeks now.
What's gotten into you today, huh?
I am not going to stand by and let you use somebody who can't defend himself.
You're going to take Rachel Corey's son's side against me?
If Matthew gets hurt, so does Josie, and I won't have it.
I'm not doing anything against
Josie. Oh, yes, you are, and you know it. You know precisely what you're doing and why.
Yeah, I think this whole thing is just a big misunderstanding.
Oh, okay? No, I don't buy that, Jason. I don't buy it.
Look, it's not between Matthew and me. It's between Matthew and his folks.
So then how come you're involved?
He came to me.
Why would Matthew do that?
Because he needed somebody to talk to, somebody to confide in, and he didn't have anybody else. I was trying to help him.
I don't believe you, Jason.
Frankly, Sharlene, I don't care whether you believe it or not.
Mr. Blake, I was blessed when I found you. I know you don't realize it, but you really are my strength. And I count on you in so many ways. You have such high standards, not just for yourself, but for other people. You are a wonderful father and a good friend to your son. And I have learned so much just watching how you're always there for him. I love you, Mitch Blake. You bring such joy to my life every day with your quiet resolve and comfort. I want to grow old with you and live beside you for all of my life. You really are the best thing that ever happened to me. And I will cherish every moment of our lives together. Always.
You have made this the happiest day of my life. And what a beautiful day and beautiful place it turned out to be. I admit it. You were right. But then again, you're usually right. I love you, and I look forward to our future. You happen to be the most beautiful, exciting, vibrant woman that I've ever known. And I will never let you go.
to Felicia. Now pledge together your love and devotion.
I, Mitch, take thee, Felicia, as my wedded wife.
I, Felicia, take thee, Mitch, as my wedded husband.
I promise
to be loving and faithful, in plenty and in want, in joy and sorrow, in sickness and in health.
For as long as we
both shall live.
I give thee this ring in token and pledge of my constant faith and abiding love.
Let us pray. Lord, bestow upon these thy servants the seal of thine approval and love. Grant them grace to fulfill with pure and steadfast affection the vow between them made. Guide them together in the way of righteousness and peace, and bless them with the tokens of thine everlasting favor. Amen. By the authority committed to me, I now pronounce you husband and wife, whom God therefore hath joined together, let no man put asunder. You may kiss the bride.
Thank you.